All right, whatever. Those just bring up the next one.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Please welcome to the stage, Mr. Alan Hawkins.
Yeah. My name is Alan, and you probably see from this how he misspells it. It's actually A-L-A-N, which is an Andrew Mangle. And my initials are A-H, which is short for arsehole. And the irony of this is my wife didn't discover that for a number of years into our marriage. Thank goodness. Anyway, you can tell from my accent I'm from around here. I'm originally from London, England. And that's where the Geico geckos live. That's where they all come from. There's thousands of these little green creatures all around London saying, would you like to save 15% on your coverage? Now, I live here all the time. I'm not a snowbird. Do we have any snowbirds here? Anybody who admits to being a snowbird?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, if you're not sure, here's a little test you can take. Drive out on the Siesta Key, and if you don't see any cars in front of you, but you look in your rearview mirror, and it looks like you're leading a very irate funeral procession, you're probably a snowbird. So a great bumper sticker the other day said, since it's snowbird season, does that mean we can shoot them? Oh, wish we could. Now, of course, most of these snowbirds are retirees. And did you hear, there's a purpose-built town in Florida now just for retirees called The Villages. Have you heard of this place? I Googled it and I couldn't believe what I read. Now, you know, like teenagers like to have sex in the back of the car. Well, all these senior citizens are doing it on golf carts. Can you picture that? Grandma and grandpa, half naked, banging on a golf cart. Hey, Doris, let's try that reverse cowgirl. Let me put it into reverse. Beep, 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 beep. And there's a hospital there. That's how big this town is. And they've actually had to add an infectious diseases ward to the hospital. It's true. The reason is they've got the highest instances of gonorrhea, syphilis, and herpes anywhere in Florida. Google is true. Now, I'm not quite old enough to go and live in the villages yet. I'm getting close to it. But I do have long-term care. And I heard that if you can meet certain criteria, you can have a nurse come in the morning, get you out of bed, and wash you. So I'm thinking, wow, that's great. So there's me with my morning woody on. This hot nurse comes, bathes me, gets me out of bed, and the insurance company pays for it. Perfect. So I call them up, and they said, well, you have to meet certain criteria, and we have to send you to a doctor for evaluation. I said, fine. So I go to the doctor, and he says, well, you've got to meet certain criteria. It's 2 out of 6 called ADLs. I don't think we have any medical people in here, but you can back me up on this. It's called activities of daily living. So I go to the doctor and he says, right, the first question is, can you dress yourself? I said, well, you know, some days I'm not colour coordinated, but, you know, it's okay. Now, can you wash? Well, again, some days are better than others. Can you feed yourself? I said, well, does driving through the McDonald's drive-thru count as feeding yourself? Evidently it does. So he says, then, what about transferring? I said, what do you mean by transferring? He said, well, can you get yourself out of bed and into a chair? I said, well, that depends. If I have had a lot to drink the night before, then I'm absolutely shit-faced. I can't move the next morning. He says, well, I'll give you half a point for that. Okay. So the next thing is, are you incontinent? Do you suffer from incontinence? I said, well, that really relates to the previous question, doesn't it? I'm not proud of it, but I have been incontinent if I can happen. He said, well, all right, we'll give you another half a point for that. So he's got one more question left. And he handed me a roll of toilet paper. So I thought, ha, I'll afford him with this. And he had a screen in the corner of his room, and it was Donald Trump giving one of his presidential electoral speeches. So I threw the toilet paper at the screen. Well, evidently throwing toilet paper at any of the current presidential candidates is a valid use of toilet paper. So I can't remember. Thank you.
you. Alright, let's just keep it going because I'm gonna punish you from a little discipline for not giving me what I need, so this time you're not getting it.